A moment of meditation, joy of Zion Church. I am a spirit. I have a soul. I live in a body. I am a new creation. God loves me. God blesses me. God makes me righteous. God gives me peace that the world cannot give. I am grateful. I am thankful. I am delighted. I am happy. I am joyful. I am okay. I am doing good. In Christ, I'm a person with overwhelming confidence to win in any situation and circumstance. I am a victor, not a victim. In Christ, I'm a person who has the ability to control my inner climate, regardless of external circumstances. I am a spirit having the spirit. In Christ, I'm a person who has the ability to maintain a positive attitude in a negative situation. I am blessed to be a blessing. I will never, never, never be the same again. The word on your lips. Through faith, we understand that the world was framed by the word of God, so that things which are seen were not made of things which do appear. Hebrews chapter 11, verse 3. There are three important words to note in our theme verse. They are framed, was, and world. The word framed is translated from the Greek katartizo, and it means to restore or mend. World is translated from the Greek ion, which means course of life, the structure and administration or seasons and times of one's life on earth. World, on the other hand, is translated from the Greek word rhema, and it means the spoken and active word to a specific person, for a specific purpose, at a specific time. From the foregoing, we observe that the ions were framed, mended, restored by the word rhema of God. The expression rhema of God, as you find in the New Testament, is never applied to God talking by himself, but to God putting his word in man's heart for man to speak. So our theme verse doesn't mean that God was framing the ions. It means that men framed their words, course of life, by using the word of God. They uttered rhema. With rhema, you give shape, structure and beauty to your world, to your life. You construct the conditions, what your world and life should be like, with the word on your lips. What's your life like today? Do you want a life of ever-increasing grace, glory and dominion? The key is your mouth. It makes no difference what obtains presently in your ion. You can mend what needs mending. You can restore what needs restoration. You can fix anything that's been ruined. You can quell terror and put a halt to the malicious destructions and havoc the devil seeks to wreak in your world, life, family, city, or country, or in the lives of your loved ones by uttering the word of God that your spirit has taken a hold of. Use the word. Put it on your lips and use it to keep the adversary in his place. Use it to frame the course of your life to be consistent with God's plan and purpose for your life. Hallelujah. Confession. Dear Heavenly Father, I thank you for the course of my life is consistent with your perfect will, plans, and purposes. I live victoriously over the adversary and the adversities of life. The word on my lips puts me over. I reign in dominion over circumstances. In Jesus' name, amen. I hope so much Jesus be inside you and covers you today. Have a glorious day or have a glorious night. See you tomorrow.